I don't know what to do. I mean, I really don't know.
I mean, my personal preference is to have this all done today if possible.
Well, absolutely. But then the question is, do I have a time limit? No, but if they get past 10 o'clock, I don't know what we do.
Right. Yeah, because my big concern about coming back tomorrow is that I do have a scheduled court appearance.
All right. Well, I know.
And a court an hour from here, so.
Where are you going?
Federal court in Lexington.
That's like, it's quite a ways. I mean, that's an hour and 15, I'd say. At least. Yeah, and I don't really know. I mean, I just don't know if.
Okay. Well, I guess we'll reach that bridge if we come to it.
And hopefully we don't have to. All right, well, look. So, okay, I'll send you a text. All right, thanks.
Going,
did you sleep in today, Mr. Masters?
I did a little bit. I was such a late night last night.
Party on.
You take credit card?
No. We passed this thing to December the 19th. You pay it any time before then, and we don't need to see you back here.
Okay. Right. Cash? I got to pay cash?
Or check.
Okay.
I mean, you can do it with a card, but it costs you a bunch of money. I mean, you have to pay more than your normal sort of service fee. So it runs into money is all I'm saying.
No, that's cool. You said 19th?
Of December. So pay it, you know, you can pay it up to midnight anytime.
Okay. Downstairs? Right. Downstairs or
yes,
do I go to you?
Downstairs at the window.
I thought you were very fair in your proceedings. And I apologize for my mother.
But, you know.
So,
I'm just glad they didn't foul the trial. I was a little worried that we were going to foul the trial and then, you know. So anyway, it'll work out. And I'm probably just, how about this? You know, be careful. I mean,
yeah.
What are you doing? Anyway, that's it.
I should have ran, but I mean, like, what would you have done? What would you have done?
I'm not going to fight anybody. I don't care how small they are. I'd have been in legitimate surrender mode from the beginning, and let them be the aggressor, and then all bets are off.
Nonviolent all the way? Pacifist.
Yeah, to truly protect yourself, you know,
right.
Not be the aggressor. I'm really surprised they didn't put you in jail.
Really?
And they might have said, well, that nose you got is what you get for this.
Yeah. Well, I would have disagreed. I feel like if you flipped it around, if the police officer's in the middle of the road and I about ran him over and I cussed at him, he wouldn't have done nothing to me.
He'd have drug you out of the car and whip you.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, that's what I did. That's then. Okay, so.
You better get out of here.
No, you're fine. You're fine.
All right.
Thank you, Your Honor.
All right, you too. I'm good. Now, Carl, we're on the record now.
How are you?
I have been put on the record. I just put on the record just to
get
started. Now, have you met Mr. Stegmaier? This is Ian.
Ian Stegmaier. Nice to meet you, Carl.
Nice to meet you.
All right. Now, he has Mr. Shore filed a motion to allow Mr. Stegmaier to come in pro hoc vici, and apparently all that's in order. He's paid his money and so on and so forth, and he's in good standing in Ohio, so he's coming in. Now, are there any sort of pretrial issues that we need to talk about?
I don't have any pretrial issues, Judge. Nothing that I just can't deal with in the form of an objection.
All right.
Quite honestly, I mean, I think that this is...
Okay. Simple case, not real complicated.
We've got just a couple.
All right.
One is we may want to use this diagram and opening, and... Are you guys the officers involved? Okay, so you guys, is this fair and accurate at the intersection? Just kind of look at it. I got.
All right, and a question to you, Mr. Price, do you have any problems with Mr. Stegmaier using that in his opening?
I don't have a problem with it.
Okay,
it seems to be,
sure.
Here we go. Here's a direction up here to north. Mm-hmm. I would ask that you put a direction for east and west because one of those streets going north and south,
Yeah. So it's universal, though, Carl. It's universal. If you know where north is, you know where west is. I'm just saying.
Judge,
that's me.
We're dealing with the jury. All of our people are on jurors. Our jurors, sometimes it's not that simple. So
That
would be the only modification I would ask.
I'll do it right now.
Okay. All right. Next.
We received a couple of videos in the mail yesterday that I believe the Commonwealth sent on Monday. One of them, we played it on a couple of different computers and couldn't get it to open, so we have absolutely no idea.
This one right here,
what's on there?
It just says video 12F.
You know anything about those, Mr. Price?
I do. I know about the videos, but
what are
I think
they?
They're two of the same. They are, basically, Judge, I would tell you they're videos, first and foremost, that were not, I think they're the same. Were you all able to open up these videos?
There was only one video on
here.
There was
only one video, okay.
This one, I have no idea what's on it because we weren't able to open it.
Okay.
At that part. But let me see if Mr. Price knows what those,
yeah.
Are they the same video?
They are not the same video. This is actually a compilation of the videos that were produced in the civil case.
Okay.
You all have those videos from the civil case. My understanding is discovery has been done in the civil case, and the WDRB TV video, the YouTube video of LMPD subs 1 and 2 of this particular.
That one was not on this one. That was on the YouTube one.
Okay.
This one right here that we got yesterday.
Let's do this, Mr. Price. Okay. I'm getting confused, and somehow we're going to have to identify them as video 1 and video 2. And the one that the defense could not open is what?
Those are YouTube. My understanding, and I have to go back and just double check my records, but they both are identified.
How about this, Mr. Price? Do you intend to introduce those?
Not in my case in chief, Judge.
All right.
But I may use them for purposes of impeachment if necessary.
Okay. And so are they videos of the defendant's interviews?
No, they are videos that the defendant made. Well, first, one is a television station video. It's an interview where he gave a statement.
The defendant did, yes. On television?
Sir. On television.
And you're all familiar with that?
I have seen that.
You have?
I have seen that one.
All right. Okay, what's the next one?
The other two are videos, and I think it's on this one, doesn't it? These videos separated myself. They're videos of the defendant basically making comments about Louisville Metro Police Department, and he titles these videos LMPD Sucks.
Okay. Okay, and are these YouTube videos?
These are YouTube videos,
okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, are you all familiar with those?
I only received those in the mail yesterday.
Okay, but hang on for a second.
Okay.
Okay, so you've never seen them before yesterday?
Before yesterday, I had not. I had, I think Mr. Cassie had mentioned the possibility that it might be out there, but I had never seen it before yesterday, and there was one 15-minute video is what that is.
Do you know what it is, Mr. Price? So that disc that you have there has several videos. One is an interview that the defendant gave on television somewhere.
That's
the
correct.
Second one is his YouTube video that I guess he created himself, to the best of your knowledge.
Two videos of this.
Two videos, yes. That he created, the defendant created himself.
That's correct, sir.
All right. All right. And anything else on there?
For some reason, I think, Judge, there's four items on here. I've got so many videos.
And you all were not able to open that up at all?
No, the only one I was able to open up was the one 15-minute video yesterday.
Okay, and what's that one 15-minute video?
It's entitled LMPD Sucks.
Okay, so that's on one video?
That's only one 15-minute clip.
Okay, and that's one 15-minute clip, and that must be the YouTube that he created is on one disc.
Yes.
Then the second disc here is the one that's up in the air.
And if you want to take a moment to take a look and see what is actually on her, since they couldn't, I didn't know until today that they couldn't open it up.
Right.
Our problem is, and let me just tell you my challenge with trying to identify exactly what's on her, although I have an index of what was on these videos, is that the defendant has made 800 some odd videos that we were able to, you know, somehow
access.
Put our hands on, you know, and access. I just want to make sure that I'm clear what I'm representing to the court is on her. I think there are four items on here, WDRB, two LMPD Sucks, and I think there's another video that I'm not quite sure of.
There's a fourth LMPD Sucks that was deleted that we were able to retrace and get.
Gotcha. Okay. So there's maybe three LMPD Sucks videos on here.
All right. And they're all they're created by the defendant.
That's correct.
Except for the WDRB, which was an interview that he gave to the television station.
That's correct.
And that's what you believe is on that right there.
That's correct, Your Honor.
All right.
And, Your Honor, as far as the videos go, I don't know if we should address them as they come up or if I should make an oral motion in limine as far as they go. I know his account of the incident is on a couple of videos.
That's going to be the defendant's account.
Correct.
Right.
Right. Now, I understand them wanting to bring one in for impeachment purposes, but not several, because that would be duplicative, I think.
Well, okay. And it goes like this.
Sure.
So, and Mr. Price has represented that he would only introduce those. He's not going to introduce any of these videos, any of them, in his case in chief. Is that true?
That's correct, Your Honor.
So the only purpose that he would use these would be for the purpose of impeachment. Now, and the purpose of impeachment would certainly be, you'd have to lay sort of a foundation. He asks the defendant questions, the defendant, you know, makes a statement that he believes can be disproven by playing one of these.
Okay. Fair enough.
And then whatever it is, and I don't know how you're going to do that, Mr. Price, to focus in on, you know, that part which is impeachment, as opposed to rambling, ranting and raving, or whatever it is. I've not seen these videos. I have no idea what these videos are.
I can just point us to the actual place in the video. I mean, that's why I've got the laptop and the iPads here.
Okay. That being said, Mr. Stegmaier, what do you got to say about all that?
No, I think if it's just one section for impeachment, I'm good.
Okay.
Yes.
Here's one of these for you, one of these for you, Carl.
Thank you.
Something else? Mr. Stegman, you got any other pretrial motions?
No pretrial motions, Your Honor. Just wanted to see if you guys had any exhibits.
Yes, we do. Be the defendant. How many are you going to need?
That's all I should need,
okay.
Your Honor. And then are we numbered or letters?
Numbered.
Okay, thank you.
All right. You're going to need to move out of that row there, sir. Yeah. Are you all ready for the jury?
Is the jury here?
Yes, it is.
They're here. Let me see. Judge, is this our?
That's yours. That's the county attorney.
I wonder why she gave me another video.
You put one through five, questionnaires. Six through ten or whatever. Put five on a row. Let's put five on a row.
Correct. It'll be five and then six will be behind one.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
Judge, is this computer connected to that monitoring?
You got to talk to Mr. Cooper. I don't know anything about him.